Match game 74, production number 0169, air date to be announced, VTR 22374. Take one.
Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy, Brett Summers, Dick Gaudier, Elaine Joyce, Richard Dawson, and Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
You took the tan coat from one suit and the brown pants from another and put them together for a new outfit.
Sorry, you noticed I'll have to change now during the commercial. What did you change? Oh, Elaine Joyce is number one fan. That's you. What the hell? She said number two fan. All right, I'll join her fan club.
Yeah, where do you join up?
Where do you join? Well, listen, it's
right
nice
at the waist there. Yeah. Comes together.
What do you think? Would you remind me once again, Anne? I've forgotten the name of the movie. You've never written a feature film before, have you?
No, I am working
never
on a
anything.
New...
Thank
yes, you. Yeah.
I'm working on a new television series pilot right now. It's going to star Catherine Coleman and Bebe Rebozo. What's it called?
What's it called?
Gee, I'm glad you asked. It's called Miracle on Wall Street. That was it.
We wish you the very best of luck with that venture.
Yes,
now, let's say hello to our current champion, Kathleen Ellis, who has $6,200 to her credit. Hi, Kathleen.
Hi.
Are you feeling cool?
Better.
Good. We didn't have a chance to meet her challenger. We're about to start a brand new game here. Kathy Roberts, would you please tell us about yourself?
Well, I'm a secretary, and I live in Manhattan Beach, and I play tennis and ride bikes. And
really? You're an outdoorsy type girl.
Yes.
Tennis is fun, isn't it?
Yes.
And you play around in your neighborhood, do you?
Yes.
Yeah, I'll come around your neighborhood. I'll bring my racket and see if I can pick up the game with you there, all right? I'm not very good, so please be kind. Kathy and Kathleen, we will start this game right after we pass along this message of interest to one and all concerned who are gathered here with us on this day, dear friends. Here we go. I'm going to push the button here and reveal two questions and ask Kathy Roberts, our challenger, to make a selection.
B.
She wants B. Brand new game, folks. Are you ready?
Yes.
I'm as ready as I'll ever be, honey.
Naturally. Sit down there and play the game right there. The secretary said, Mr. Goldstein, brace yourself. Your wife is here with a blank.
Darling, you're going to have to do that all over again.
You didn't hear me.
Well, I heard part of it, but your acting was so good I got involved and I didn't hear the word.
The secretary said, Mr. Goldstein, brace yourself. Your wife is here with a blank.
With a blank what?
Well, I don't know.
Oh, with a blank.
With a blank.
Do I know?
All right. The lower tier is all ready.
Gotta be.
Brett.
Brett, come on.
Were you often left back in school? When the rest of the class passed ahead? Yes. Thank you.
One of those every 3 miles.
One of these every 3 miles. Okay, thank you. Now, Kathy, we call on you. They're all finished over there. The secretary said, Mr. Goldstein, brace yourself. Your wife is here with a blank.
Gun.
Gun. Ba-da-dum, 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 gun, gun. She said gun, 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 gun. What do you say? What do you say?
Mm-hmm. Gee, I'm terrified I'll be in the wrong key. Your wife is here with a lawyer, I said.
The gun comes before the lawyer.
Yes, it's true. That's what I've heard.
Brent, what do you say?
Have an egg roll, Mr. Goldstein. Daddy, well, anyway, I said priest.
Mr. Goldstein's wife brought a priest already?
He was married to an Irish Catholic.
Oh, I see.
Her name was Maureen Irving Stapleton.
I see. Okay. All right, Dick.
Well, I said the very same thing, but Boyd Convey, a lawyer, is what I said.
You said a lawyer.
I think it makes sense. I love the ends. I'll kiss myself on my face.
What sensible...
Who is he imitating?
I don't know.
He's imitating
Mr. Goldstein.
And Mr. Goldstein, he's...
Well, you acted it out so well.
Yes.
And, but that's no excuse. So I said, gun.
Gun.
There's a match, Kathy.
I wouldn't want to be very tricky.
So there's one match for Kathy. Does she match you, sir?
Are you kidding?
Do you know if your name was Gina Lola Brigida, you'd have to wear an overcoat?
The answer is gun.
Gun is the answer. There is another match. Now let's go down to sweet demure Ann Elder and see what she says.
We went for the mouthpiece. We said the lawyer.
The lawyer. Uh-huh. So there were lawyers and guns all over the place, and that was two for you. And now let's see what we have for Kathleen. Everybody plays here, since it's the first round. The king lost the key to the queen's chastity belt, so he tried to pick the lock with his blank. Madam, are you feeling hysterical? The king lost the key, you see, to the queen's chastity belt. So he tried to pick the... Those things, that really happened in those olden days. Someone would have... What a dingbat he must have been to lose the key. Especially, I hear she was a rather attractive queen, too, as queens go. We're waiting. Listen.
We're through and they're not.
Do my old nightclub act while you're waiting here. All right, Paris, ready now. Kathleen, did you hear the question? Well, I'll read it again as long as you'd like to hear it again. The king lost the key to the queen's chastity belt, so he tried to pick the lock with his blank.
You're going to die, but I'm going to say teeth.
It is teeth.
Don't die.
Don't die.
I'm not going to die, but I tell you, I'm feeling very faint. So, I'm calling Bert Convey to show his answer, and I don't want to see what it is. What do you say?
Somebody give that man artificial something or other. I said pick it with his scepter, is what I said.
With his scepter?
Reason for teeth, of course.
Okay. No, no match there. Teeth is the answer she gave. Brett, what do you say?
What? I say, oh, wow. He had these wonderful Shirley Temple curls.
Yes.
And he used to have to put them up every night. Yes. So he picked it with his hairpin.
Aha! Very clever of that king.
Not very clever. It was fair.
King probably was really a... Well, the Dick, what do you say?
I got it without your saying it. Anyway, no, mine was mace. He picked it with his mace, because isn't that what he... That's what he carries.
Yeah, the
king's
mace. Yeah.
Mace, okay.
And sprays in your face.
That's right. Mace is known as a chemical today, yes. Now, what did this king do who was in this terrible dilemma, my dear? Tell us.
Well, he did what everybody else would do. He just picked the lock with his teeth.
There you go, Kathleen.
Teeth? How do you pick it with your teeth?
I don't know, but Richard...
I always thought it was very bad.
I'm not going to ask. What?
Very bad form to pick your teeth.
Yes.
I said mace.
Mace. Okay. Now, Anne, what did this king do?
If you know anything about picking locks, you know, they say that you can use credit cards, right?
Right.
So I said, knowing that it was in England, I said his Bank of London card.
His Bank of London card.
You know, see, that's what I said.
Your logic is terrific. I'm glad you explained the whole thing.
Somebody get a baggie and put over her head.
2-1 the score here at the end of round one in favor of our challenger, Kathy. And we'll come back to you two ladies in a moment or so. But first, folks, we've got this for you. Oh, here we go, friends, with round two. I'll push the button and reveal the questions for Kathy to make a selection.
Gene, I have a question.
You have a question?
Yeah.
What
is that? Why are all the contestants young and pretty?
I must explain, someone in the studio audience during the commercial break said, how come the contestants are always young and pretty? We were just funning around here. And,
what did you say to that, Gene?
What was it called?
I said because our producer
is
had a very powerful libido. And that's the answer. Okay. Now, Kathy, shall we press on?
Yes.
All right, shall we press on, Kathy? What do you want here?
A.
Kathy had a little trouble making up. She wants A. Did you match it? Yes, you matched Richard and Elaine, so the two of you lay out. Okay. Now, the rest of you...
do not participate. Where you want to lay out.
Do not participate in this question, that's all. I meant by that. Nothing else. The restaurant manager said to the waitress, "I don't mean to criticize, but your blank keeps dipping in the soup." The restaurant manager said to the waitress, "I don't mean to criticize, but your blank keeps dipping in the soup."
Okay.
Aren't you sorry you're not playing now?
What did you say about the producer of this show?
I said... He's a guy. He's a guy with a powerful libido.
What does that mean?
Well, libido is a German word which was invented by Freud. Well, yeah, I guess it was invented by Freud, and it means life force, life's energy. All right, everybody, finish over there. I will call on Kathy for her response. The restaurant manager said to the waitress, "I don't mean to criticize, but your blank keeps dipping into this in the soup."
Your tie.
The waitress? Okay, tie is the answer. I have to accept it. She might have misunderstood, but I read it as clearly as I could.
And you read it twice, did you not?
That's right.
In English, too, I think.
Bert, what did you say? She said tie.
I said her apron.
Apron would be a good response. Sorry. Brett, how about you?
Well, I don't know, but all I... Her buttons.
Her buttons?
Waitress, and you bend over, and you say, "I used to be a waitress for a brief time. I was fired." And you bend over like that.
Well, it's not your buttons that are up.
They can dip into the. Go on to here.
It's true. Yeah. She waited on me, and all I tasted were buttons.
So that's where all the buttons went.
That's right. Yeah, she lost all her buttons.
Dick, I said thumb because that's what people dip in soup is thumbs.
Yeah. Don't mean to say your thumb is getting in here.
All right,
the waiter, I don't mean to criticize, but your blank keeps dipping in the soup. What did you say, Anne?
Yeah. Well, this was a very shapely waitress. So, yeah, her bosom just kept dipping.
So, the score remains 2-1. And we go to... Wait a minute.
The only one who bit.
Yeah, we go to you. Now, you need one to tie. Two, however, will win the game. Here we go.
Do you find those quick naps help you?
Yes. Elaine, you do not play. Samantha said to Clyde, "I know you love dogs a lot, but I still don't think we should call our son blank." Samantha said to Clyde, "I know you love dogs a lot, but I still don't think we should call our son blank."
Gotcha.
Okay. Kathleen's thinking about it. And we're all set over there. Now, Kathleen, please give us your response. "I know you love dogs a lot, but I still don't think we should call our son..."
Rover.
Rover. Yay! All right. One to tie, Kathleen. Two will win another game for you. Bert, one Rover ties the game. What do you say?
Well, it had to be one or the other, and I said Fido.
Rover, Fido. Okay, that's a good response. Brett?
Roll over, roll over. Red Rover, Red Rover.
Red Rover, come over. Tie game. All right, Dick, one more Rover will win the game for her.
Well, unfortunately, since you said boy and there is a problem, I said Lassie.
Lassie.
Sorry, darling.
No.
And Lassie's the girl anyway.
Yes.
Yeah, you
no.
know. All right, Richard, does she win the game by matching you?
Oh, I don't know. I was too busy writing Fido to find
you. You were Fido. All right. One more over, and it's all up to Ann Elder.
Yeah, I was Fidoing.
You were Fidoing?
I was Fidoing.
So we got a tie.
It's a tie.
Don't go too far away. I'll tell you what happens when we have a tie right after I tell you about this message.
Today's consolation prizes are Bissell's Sweet Master Deluxe Feather Light Vacuum, Straight Through Suction, Float and Lock Brush, Flips Dirt, Pet Hair, and Linda to the Airstream from Bissell. And a complete kit for popping corn from 3-Minute Brand Color Corn, 3-Minute Color Corn, the Party Popcorn. And a supply of Airwick Solid, including Rose, Natural, and Lemon Scents in beautiful decorator colors. Airwick works 24 hours a day to help eliminate odors. We'll be back with more of Match Game 74 in 1 minute.
Oh, here we go, folks. Where are we going? Oh, I tell you, I promise I'll tell you what happens when we have a tie.
Yeah.
We wipe the slate clean, and then I push the button and reveal a tie-breaking card. One question for each of you. The one who has scored the most matches will be the winner. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, Kathy, make a selection.
B.
She wants B. Everybody plays, since this is a tiebreaker. As they left the movies, Peter said to Annette, "I can understand a woman crying at a sad movie, but you even cried during the blank." As they left the movies, Peter said to Annette, "I can understand a woman crying at a sad movie, but you even cried during the blank."
Oh! Look how she woke up.
I saw the light bulb. Light bulb lit right over her head, just like that. 150 water. Okay. All finished. Over there. Kathy Roberts, a tiebreaker. Think carefully. As they left the movies, Peter said to Annette, "I can understand a woman crying at a sad movie, but you even cried during the..."
Love scenes.
During the love scenes. Okay, the audience is owing and expressing their disapproval of your answer, Kathy, but we'll find out if it'll score for you or not.
During the cartoon.
During the cartoon. Good response. Brett?
I said she even cried during the newsreel.
Another good answer.
But now that I think about it...
That's a good answer. Yeah, very good.
I think she's right.
Yes. Dick?
I also said the best answer, cartoon.
Cartoon.
Of course.
But you even cried during the love scene is what she said. What did you say, Elaine Joyce, number one fan?
The love scene she was having with her boyfriend during the intermission.
The intermission. You even cried during the intermission. That's a good answer. Richard?
She was such a hamburger.
That.
She even cried during the credits.
During the credits. Shed a tear or two.
That's the best part.
All right,
part.
She's looking for the answer, love scenes.
She was such a sob sister that she cried during the opening titles.
That's
before
it.
The movie began.
Okay, Kathy, no match there at all for you. Now, as you know, one match for Kathleen will win the game, and this is her question. Bob said, "Have you eaten at that new restaurant in the zoo? It's wild. They have blanks as waiters." Think about it. Bob said, "Have you eaten at that new restaurant in the zoo? It's wild. They have blanks as waiters."
Ta-da,
already up there.
Dick Gaudier said I shouldn't do a musical, but I think he's wrong, don't you?
I do, too. You have a perfect pitch. Okay, Kathleen, it's up to you now. Bob said, "Have you eaten at that new restaurant in the zoo? It's wild. They have blanks as waiters."
Monkeys?
Monkeys as waiters. All right. One monkey win another game for that lady there. What do you say, Bert? Oh! Puts up to $6,300. Kathy, it's been a short but pleasant meeting for us. I hope it was pleasant for you. A gift for Kathy Roberts backstage. Many thanks for being with us on Match Game 74. Goodbye, Kathy. Okay. Now, you're going to have another go at the big money here. You know how this goes. Shall we begin it?
Yes.
Okay. We polled a recent studio audience, got their best response to this. Blank Farm. The answer they gave, you know, is worth $500, $250, and $100, depending on which one you match. Three celebrities are allowed to help a little bit. Which ones would you like?
Bert
Convy.
Thank you. I would say the Funny Farm.
Funny Farm.
Yeah.
Okay. That's the answer you get from the host of Tattle Tales, the Funny Farm.
That's
what he presides over every day following our show here. Another one.
Elaine.
I would say Animal Farm.
Animal Farm.
Richard?
And Mr. Richard Dawson.
Why don't you say Vegetable Farm? Always gets
all right,
a bigger.
I'll say vegetable.
No, it's too late.
Too late.
Rebecca of Sunnybrook Farm.
Rebecca
How
of Sunnybrook
quickly they
Farm.
Forget. That woman was a star 20 years ago.
Why didn't right, you so say you got, vegetable farm?
I will, vegetable farm.
No, too late to change.
I don't want to change. I never change.
Yes, and your trouble. That's you'll never change,
very
Richard.
Unsanitary.
That's what everybody's saying around
here. I'll sit down, you're drunk.
So what we have is Funny Farm, Animal Farm, and Rebecca of Sunnybrook Farm.
Just Sunnybrook's enough to win.
All right. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own.
Funny Farm.
Funny Farm is the answer. Here we go, looking for Funny Farm. May we see the $100 response? Old McDonald's Farm.
And you didn't even think of it. Changed the name.
To Rebecca, okay.
No people.
Still looking for Funny Farm. Here's the $250 response. Animal Farm is up there, the one that Elaine gave you. Last chance for Funny Farm. Here is the $500 response. Very good. Okay. So while she and Bert are doing their little love scene up there and kissing and hugging and all. Oh, you finished. Okay, Kathleen has stepped aside because our time is up for today. We just got a few seconds to say goodbye to thank all of these celebrated and beautiful people who are so terrific today, as they are every time they appear. And that moment of hostility that occurred between Richard Dawson and myself, you know, we were just funning.
Oh, yeah.
We do like each other a lot.
I happen to love him. But I still won't change.
I think you have already.
Better?
Hollywood got to you at last. Then. All right, Gene Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time. Thank you. Bye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of the CBS stations.